In this video, I will show you how to create this amazing Happy New Year greeting animation inside of Adobe After Effects without using any plugin. It is going to be super easy to create and looks very, very cool. Hey everyone, this is Vikash from Skyline Motions, and no more waiting. Let's jump right into After Effects and get started. Let's go. Alright, so this is Adobe After Effects, and let's start by creating a new composition. So just go to the composition, take a new composition, and this is gonna be our main composition. You can also call it render comp. I'm using this size 1920 by 1080, which is a full HD resolution, frame rate 60, duration make it 5 seconds long, background color black, hit OK. Now we have to import some files for this animation, so just go to the project window, right click on that, go to import file, and I'm using these 4 files for this animation. This is a background, this is a sparkle video, and both are downloaded from pixels.com, and I will give you a link in the description. So you can download this video clip for free, and this is the HDRI image. You can use any HDRI, whatever you like, and this is the burn transition. You can use any transition, whatever you like, but burn transition is good, so you can use this burn transition, and you will get all the files with the project file, so you can download the project file from the link given in the description. Once you have downloaded this file, just select it and click on import. And I will place all the files into a folder. So simply you can drag all the files on this little folder icon over here, and you will get a new folder. I'm gonna call it asset. Perfect. Open the asset folder, and here we have all the files. And I'm gonna use this video clip, which is a background. So let's create a new composition for the background. So just go to the composition, take a new composition, and this is gonna be our background. So I'm gonna call it busy. Leave the setting as it is, hit OK, and now let's drag and drop the video clip inside of the background composition. Here we have this type of background, so simply drag this clip and place it like this. I'm gonna use this video clip from here to here. As you can see, it is looking perfect. Just go to the main composition, and here we have to import the background composition. Let's drag and drop outside of the folder. And let's drag and drop the background inside of the main composition. And here we have a background. Now let's turn off the visibility of the background for a moment. So select the text tool, go to the character, and here we have to select our favorite font style first. So in this case, I'm using this font style Heavenly Christmas, which is a personal use font style. I will give you a link in the description so you can download this font style, or you can use any font style that you like. Once you have select the font style, just set the size of the font. I'm gonna use this size 350 pixel, and this is the line spacing. So I'm gonna use this value 300 pixel for line spacing, and then you can click over here and type anything whatever you like, such as Happy New Year. And now select the move tool, and let's align this text in the center. So just go to the align. If you don't have the align window, then go to window and check this option align, and click on the align horizontally and vertically. Basically, we have to set the text in the center. So this is our text. Now let's create a 3D kind of text. So it's very simple. Select the text layer, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and this is going to be the text layer. So let's call it text. Check this second option, move all attributes into the new composition, hit OK. And then we have to apply some effect on the text layer. So right click on the text, go to the layer style, and this is the bevel and emboss. So select this option, bevel and emboss, and this is the bevel and emboss option. And here we have the size. So I'm gonna set the size value something around 20, and this is the height opacity. I'm gonna set the value 100, and we will get this type of output. Perfect. Now select the text layer, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and this is gonna be the bevel. So let's call it bevel text. Perfect. Select the second option, hit OK. Now let's create a reflection layer. So it's very simple. Just drag and drop the HDRI into this main composition, and this is the image. Hit S to bring out the scale property. Let's scale it up just a little bit. You can set the value something around 200%. Perfect. And I'm gonna apply a motion tile effect on it. So just go to effect and preset and search for motion tile. So this is the motion tile effect. Let's apply this on the HDRI image, and here we have the output width. I'm going to set the value 300 and output height 150. Perfect. And here we have this option, mirror edges. So check this option and make it like this. And after that, we have to animate this HDRI image. Let me tell you, you can download any HDRI image. Simply go to the Google and search for HDRI image, and you will get lots of HDRI. You can use any HDRI, whatever you like. And now just go to the end of this animation, hit P to bring out the position property, and this is the X parameter and this is the Y. I'm gonna animate the X value. So what we have to do, set the position value 600 and turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe at the end of this animation right over here. And then just go to very first frame of this animation and move this image on the right hand side and set the value something around 1200. Perfect. So we will get this type of animation. And then just right click on this HDRI image, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and this is going to be the reflection. Check the second option, hit OK. And now let's import the text composition into the main composition. So just go to the project window, and this is the text composition. Let's drag and drop the text composition into this main composition. You can place this text composition over on the reflection composition. Select the reflection, click on the toggle switches. Here we have to change the track mat. So click on the track mat and select this option text, and we will get this type of effect. Now you can turn off the bevel text, and then we have to apply some effect on this reflection. So just go to the effect and preset and search for CC glass. So this is the CC glass effect. Let's apply this on reflection and open the surface. In the bump map option, here we have to select this bevel text, and let's change some settings. So this is the softness. I'm going to set the value 10, height value 100, displacement 100, and we will get this output, which is looking pretty nice. And now let's apply one more effect, which is the CC blobbylize. So this is the CC blobbylize effect. Let's apply this on reflection. And here we have to open this blobbylize option, and we have to change the blob layer. So let's select this layer, bevel text, and this is the softness. I'm going to set the value 10. And finally, we will get this type of 3D kind of text, which is looking absolutely perfect, as you can see. And now what we have to do, just turn on the background, and here we have something like this. Now select the bevel text, reflection, and the text layer. Right click on that, click on pre-compose, and this is gonna be the 3D text. So I'm gonna call it 3D text. Check the second option, move all attributes into the new composition, hit OK. And let's animate the text layer. So just go to very first frame, or maybe just go to the end of this animation first. Hit S to bring out the scale property. Turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the scale property. Go to very first frame of this animation, and this is the scale. Let's increase the value and set it to 120%. And now we have a zoom out animation, as you can see, which is looking nice. And after that, we have to apply some effect on it. So just go to the project window, and here we have this video clip, which is a sparkle kind of video clip. So what we have to do, let's drag and drop the video clip on this little composition icon and create a composition using this video clip. And we have a 40-second video clip, as you can see. Now let's select 5 seconds of this video clip. So I'm gonna use this video clip from here. So place the CTI right over here, hold Ctrl Shift D by selecting this layer, and I split the layer, just delete the bottom layer, and this is the video clip. Let's drag and drop at very beginning of this animation right over here. All right, and I want to use the 5 second clip of this. So what we have to do, just go to the composition, click on the composition setting, and here we have to change the duration. So this is a 40 second long video clip, so I want to change this to 05. It means 5 seconds. Leave the setting as it is, hit OK. And now you can close the layer. And here we have the new composition. Let's drag and drop outside of this folder. right click on that, click on rename, and this is gonna be the sparkle. Perfect. And I'm gonna use this sparkle into this main composition. So drag and drop into this main composition, placed it over here, over on the text layer. Perfect. And then just go to the blending mode, select the blending option screen, and you will get something like this. Now select the sparkle, go to effect and preset and search for glow effect. So this is the glow. Let's apply this on a sparkle, and here we have the glow intensity and glow radius. I'm gonna set the glow radius 20, and it's looking perfect now. And then we have to adjust the color. So what we have to do, just go to layer, go to new and take a new adjustment layer, right click on that, click on rename, and this is going to be the color. Now let's apply some effect on this color adjustment layer. So just go to the effect and preset and search for curves. So this is the curves adjustment. Let's apply this on the color layer, and here we have to select the blue channel, and let's increase the blue saturation just a little bit. And then we have to apply one more effect, which is the hue and saturation. So this is the hue and saturation effect. Let's apply this on color adjustment. And here we have the master saturation. So let's increase the master saturation value. I'm going to set the value something around 20, and we will get something like this. You can adjust the blue saturation according to you. Perfect. And now we have this type of 3D text animation, as you can see. You can also adjust these sparkle video clip. So you can simply double click on this sparkle, adjust the video clip according to you. You can simply move the video clip by holding this. Perfect. Now just go to the main composition, and here we have this type of sparkle effect. And after that, let's apply some transition on it. So what we have to do, just go to the project window, and this is the burn transition. You can use any transition, whatever you like. So this is the burn transition. Let's drag and drop into this main composition. Here we have to select the blending mode screen, and as you can see, this is the burn transition. So just go to the center of this burn transition, maybe on this frame where we have this white color. Select this burn transition, hold Ctrl Shift D to split the layer. Here we have two different layers. So what we have to do, this is the first layer, right click on that, click on rename and call it int. And this is the second layer, so right click on that, click on rename, and you can call it start. Perfect. And then what we have to do, select the second clip and place it at very beginning, right over here, and move this first clip at the end of this animation, just like that. And now what we have to do is go to full screen, click on fit button, and let's have a look. Alright, so it is looking pretty amazing, right? So that is the wrap for today. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and get the value from it. If you did, then please subscribe to this channel and like this video to appreciate my hard work. And also, do comment below this video if you have any question or thoughts. My name is Vikash, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.